Bonjour et bienvenue. Welcome back to Adventures in Language. I'm your guide, Caitlin. In this video, we're facing our fears about learning new languages. That's right. We're talking about why and how anxiety rears its head when we learn languages and how it affects the learning process. We even have a free worksheet with 5 steps to help you manage language anxiety by taking control of your language learning journey. Check out the link in the description. Are you ready? Let's get started. Today's video is part of a set of videos about the individual factors that influence language learning. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and be the first to know when new videos come out. Okay, so picture this. You're in your German class, following along as your teacher and classmates talk about their weekends. Everything's going fine. Then your teacher calls on you and you freeze. Your palms are sweating, your heart's racing, and you can't manage to say anything. Or maybe you've studied hard for an Arabic vocab quiz and know your flashcards by heart, but you completely blank out on the answers when it's time to actually take the quiz. And language learning anxiety isn't restricted to the classroom. You might get nervous trying to order food or speak to a group of people in your second language. When it comes down to it, anxiety is very common among language learners, and it's a very important factor in language learning. So let's start with some basic facts. Language learning anxiety is any feeling of fear, tension, or worry that people experience when they're learning or using a second language. It's not an inherent trait that you either have or you don't. In fact, anyone can feel anxious when learning a new language, and most people probably do at least sometimes, especially in specific situations or during certain phases of language learning. So, for example, you may feel anxious when you're exposed to new input in a foreign language, like words, phrases, sounds, or grammatical rules, and your goal is to try to remember them. This could happen if you're taking a Spanish class and your teacher is introducing the words for the days of the week or explaining how to form the past tense. It might seem simple enough, but learning new things can be overwhelming. You might feel like there are too many words to remember or that you'll never be able to pronounce a tricky sound. You also might feel worried when you have to memorize or understand something in your target language, like when you're trying to take part in a conversation or talk to someone on the phone, which can be especially hard to understand. I, for one, always feel nervous when I'm in a foreign country and have to listen out for announcements on the train because the conductor's voice or recorded message over the loudspeaker isn't very clear to begin with. Plus, the cost of missing an announcement could be missing your stop. And if you haven't experienced anxiety while learning or trying to understand something in your second language, you've almost certainly felt tension around speaking or writing. This is the most common type of language learning anxiety, and it's partially related to a fear of being judged by others, like your teacher or your peers. I don't know about you, but I certainly feel nervous when I have to perform in the spotlight, even in my first language. Anxiety comes into play in many different situations for language learners, and some situations might involve multiple types of anxiety. So for example, if you're having a conversation in your second language, you may be anxious about picking up new words that come up, understanding what the other person is saying, and trying to speak without making too many mistakes. Okay, so now you might be asking yourself, sure, but how does the anxiety I feel in these different situations affect learning? Well, at its core, language learning anxiety is a distraction. It's information in your head that isn't really relevant to what you're trying to focus on. If you've been following along in this series, you know that our minds can only hold and process so much information at once. Anxiety effectively takes up some of this space and therefore tends to interfere with learning. For instance, if you feel anxious when you hear a new word for the first time, you may be so distracted that you can't remember what it sounds like. You may even need to have it repeated a few times before you can successfully commit it to memory. This can be a problem since in the wild, we don't always have access to a replay button. Alternatively, if you feel anxious when producing language, like speaking or writing, you might not have the spare mental capacity to retrieve the word that you need, even if you painstakingly memorized it beforehand. That's right, anxiety can put you at a real loss for words. Anxiety can even interfere with your ability to recognize feedback from other people on your speaking or writing. This can definitely get in the way of language learning, as feedback is critical for language development. And so it shouldn't come as a shock that learners who experience less anxiety are able to learn and achieve more in a second language. But is anxiety always a bad thing? Most of the time, anxiety is detrimental to language learning because it shifts your focus away from the task at hand toward personal concerns, like worrying about failing or being judged by others. However, small amounts of anxiety during simple tasks, like competing during a language game, may actually boost your language performance by pushing you to put in extra effort. Okay, so anxiety is a pretty important part of understanding why people are more or less successful in language learning. But how does it match up to other factors like aptitude or motivation? Well, as it turns out, these factors influence each other and language learning in pretty interesting ways. Take aptitude, for example, which is a natural talent for language learning. Previously in the series, we've talked about the fact that learners with low levels of aptitude tend to have a harder time learning new languages. But research also tells us that low aptitude learners have higher levels of anxiety. Now, this relationship may be fairly direct. Low aptitude learners, by definition, face more obstacles to learning, which can lead to more anxiety. But while high aptitude learners might be less prone to anxiety, they're not immune to it. High levels of anxiety can actually prevent even high aptitude learners from applying their natural talents. For example, anxiety can diminish working memory capacity. What about anxiety and motivation? Both of these are emotional factors that come into play during learning. Anxiety interferes most strongly with the effort component of motivation, that is, how much work someone is willing to put into language learning. How? Well, studies have shown that learners who are more anxious are also less willing to use their second language. They're afraid of making mistakes and embarrassing themselves. So even if they're motivated by good reasons for studying a language, anxiety may make it difficult for some learners to put in the effort to get good results. Interestingly, anxiety may also be linked to a language learner's background or experience, such as their age and how many languages they speak. Younger learners who are less self-aware than adults are generally less anxious about learning languages and worry less about being negatively judged. Likewise, learners who know more languages tend to be less anxious than those who know fewer languages, likely because they're more familiar with the ins and outs of learning a new language. Okay, so now we know that some language learning situations are likely to make us anxious, and we know that anxiety isn't exactly our best friend when it comes to achieving our language learning goals. So, is there anything we can do about it? Well, the good news is that there are a few things you can do to reduce your language learning anxiety. Number one, practice with games. Using games to learn can push learners to take risks and experiment with language in ways that they wouldn't otherwise. Number two, use a language learning app. An app like Mango allows learners to practice speaking in low-pressure environments, like in the privacy of their own homes, which can reduce anxiety and improve learning. Number three, if you're able to, take an extended trip to a place where your target language is spoken, study abroad, or just look for a local meetup with speakers of your target language. Studies have shown that practice in language immersion settings can help learners feel less nervous when interacting with others. And number four, put yourself in control of your language learning journey. Research suggests that language learners who feel more in control not only have lower anxiety, but also tend to be more motivated to learn a language and achieve greater success. Not sure how to take the wheel on the road to language learning? Don't forget to check out the worksheet we've created to guide you through the process. Well, there you have it. Let's recap what we've learned. First, language learning anxiety is any feeling of fear, tension, or worry that people experience when they're learning or using a second language. It can arise in many different language learning situations. Second, anxiety is usually harmful to language learning because it distracts us from important information. But small amounts of anxiety can actually help you put in extra effort and learn more. And number three, anxiety interacts with several other individual differences in language learning, like aptitude, working memory, and motivation. And finally, we covered some tips for managing language learning anxiety. Let us know which ones work best for you. And if you have any tips that you want to share with the language learning community, tell us about them in the comments. Be sure to check out the description for this video for a worksheet you can use to gain an upper hand on language learning anxiety. Thanks for watching. À la prochaine. Hey there, me again. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to get your free goodies, which you can access right here through the link on the screen. In our next video, we'll be talking about the role of personality in language learning. If you want to be the first to know when that video goes live, then ring that notification bell. In the meantime, you can catch up on all of our existing videos right here. We'll see you next time on The Science Behind Language Learning.